Hello, I'm Mr. Origen, and I'm a lecturer in methodology. I'm a university lecturer, so I know the lecturing skill, and I can understand the things, analyze them. And I try to build the covenant of the Jewish people with Abraham, and I could not. This church father, Origen, he also tried to build the covenant of the Jews with Abraham. He said up to Isaac he can go. From Isaac to Abraham he can't. In fact, he did not know the Jew is a spiritual self and not the physical self. To the spiritual selves belong the places of worship, like synagogue, Sikh temple, mosque, etc. And this house where I'm here belong to the tribal people. This house belong to Niger and not to Sikh or Muslim or Christian or anything. So Jew is not a physical self. Jew is not physical self. That's what St. Paul said. A Jew is one who is inwardly spiritual and not physical outwardly. And here it is. Under Adam, you get races. Under races, you get tribes. And this planet Earth is for the habitation of the sons of Adam, sons of man. There are 144,000, 12,000 of each tribe, Levi tribe, Benjamin tribe, so and so, Judah tribe. Not a single Jew. Jew is a, under God come the way of life, spiritual. Jew is a spiritual self, not the physical self. Jew, Hindu, Sikh, Muslim, Christian. Never born, never died. So, not a single Jew died during the Holocaust. But the people led by their blind guide. The blind guide leading the blind, they fell into the pit of Holocaust. Now who is to be blamed? Christ Jesus came to give them the knowledge of the Oral Torah. And Oral Torah is His word, and which is common sense, which you receive through Holy Spirit, which is common sense. But they killed Him. So here is the relationship between the written scripture and the Oral Torah. This is scripture that you can read. These are written by men, and men can change it. This is the knowledge of Oral Torah. If you have the knowledge of Oral Torah, then you can rectify the scripture. You can make your own scripture. Moral laws are sound, based upon Oral Torah, which is His word. And that is why Jesus came to deliver, because the scripture has become highly corrupted. And this you can see in Genesis 17, the passage on circumcision is a typical example of corruption. Now, Abraham had two sons. The elder one, Ishmael, born of the concubine Hagar. When he was born, he did not circumcise himself. He did not circumcise Ishmael. But when Isaac was born, then he circumcised himself and circumcised Isaac. So this is a covenant of Abraham with Isaac of circumcision, which is the tribal mark. Nobody else can have it except born of the seed of Isaac or the sons of Isaac. Seed is carried by the man, not by the woman. And so this planet Earth is for the habitation of men and not for the women are misses. Women in the procreation for supplying blood. Blood is the life, and life comes from our supernatural father, Elohim Allah Fabram. So woman in religion, she represents God. She represents God, and God has no boundaries. So here it is. So these six candles, they are of Yahweh, the potter. And that Yahweh's temple, where Judah Iscariot threw the 30 shekels, and they pick up from his temple and bought a plot called potter's plot, because these are pots. This is a pot created by Yahweh. Brahma Khuda, same thing. And this middle candle is the life, life-giving blood. So women belong to this, our supernatural father. And we belong to, men belong to Yahweh. So she is the superior to men. So the light comes from the middle candle, which is called Shamus, Shamus sun, primary source of light, and they are moon, moonlight. Moses saw the face of God, and he showed the back to the people, moonlight. So these prophets and rabbis, they are reflection of his words. So Moses put on Christ, Moses saw the face of God, and he showed the back to the people. This is the back.
Can I have paper?
Yep.
Please?
Okay.
Wow.
There you are.
Oh, sorry.
Yeah, okay, go away now, I'm doing something. So, this is the John the Baptist, a witness to the light, but not the light. So, because he belongs to moon, he cannot expose the hypocrite who creates a fog between man and our supernatural father. Fog here. Because if the priest is greedy, then father won't give him anything. That's why when the first church was found, people sold all their possessions to become greed-free, mammon-free, as the sadhu Melchizedek was. And then they received the light of our supernatural father. If you have element of greed, blood money, in your system, then you won't get the light. Then you have fog here, and you become a hypocrite. And that's why the temple priest became hypocrite. And that hypocrisy could not be cleared by moon. As you know, at night time, moon shines, and the fog builds up. In the morning, sun appears, and the fog disappears. So sun is Christ Jesus. So when Christ Jesus appeared, the fog which the hypocrite had created, greedy priest had created, it disappeared. That's why Jesus was going to the temple, exposing the hypocrite. And they did not like it. Whereas Samaritan people, they are the generation of Joseph. Joseph was a good man. He was honest. he was faithful to Abraham and Yahweh. So those 11 crook brothers of Joseph, when they sold him as a slave to the Egyptians, there were none left in the promised land who were salt of Abraham. Salt means as same quality as Abraham. So the promised land became barren. And all the Abraham is the father of the faithful only, and not of the unfaithful. So Abraham kicked them out of the promised land. And they went to the Egypt. Over there they showed the same old qualities. Crook, liars. And the Egyptians, they were sons of man. And they hated them. And they made them slaves, and Moses bring them back. He turned them faithful in the wilderness. No more fighting among them. Snake was lifted up. And the same barren promised land became lush green to welcome them back into their country, promised land. This Jesus told in the parable of the prodigal son. And these university professors in Oxford, Cambridge, anything, they have not the slightest idea what I am telling you. Because I am taught by God, and they are taught by men, by this professor, that professor. So their knowledge is limited and corrupt. As you can see, they don't know Genesis 17 is a corruption. For the sake of money, they were turning Gentile and Negro and the Aryan Jew of physical self by circumcising. And when they enter the fold of Hazrat Muhammad Sahib, over there they bring everything down. Circumcision compulsory. And then the kosher is called halal. That means the blood belongs to our supernatural Father God. And that's why they drain all the blood. Telling our supernatural Father, we are not eating your thing. We are eating only the flesh, the things of the men, and not of God. Many things you can learn from them. And that throwing out of the promised land, 11 crook patriarchs, which Jesus described in John 8 verse 44, that your forefathers are liars, murderers, and super bastard fanatic devils. When he called them super bastard, then they say, we are born of legitimate parents. There is no doubt they are not born of legitimate parents. But we have two fathers. One is our flesh, father of flesh, which is tribal father. And one is our supernatural father of our souls. The soul point comes from your heart and not from the flesh. So when you become a Jew knowingly that you are tribal, your tribe is so and so, but you are knowingly become Jew, then you become a hypocrite. But the temple priests were making them Jew, and the people were innocent. And people who came to their senses came to know common sense they used. Those who had the Holy Spirit, which is common sense, they found that if they become Jew outwardly, then they can't, their tribal identity is replaced by Jew, which is wrong. They can't build their covenant with Abraham. And they went to John the Baptist to be baptized in water. And he baptized them in the name of Abraham. And Jesus was baptized in the name of his heavenly Father, Yahweh. That's why his name was Yeshua. And here it is. Then this ego of the seed, the rabbis, they boost your ego. They boost your ego, and that's why when St. James is just was telling them that in God, there's neither Jew nor Gentile, we are all equal. And then the temple priest, because they were boosting the ego, and they told their stooges, when he was preaching gospel on the pinnacle, look, he's making us equal to Gentile. So they went up and threw him down and killed him under ego. So they did not know why they are killing him. So they are forgiven, but not those temple priests, crook one, hypocrite. Same way, angel Stephen, when he was called to temple because he was baptizing Jewish men in water in the name of Abraham, and the temple priest did not want to know Abraham. So when they reported that he is doing against us, exposing us, so they called him in the temple and he gave a very nice speech that our forefather Abraham was a noble man. He was a saint. That's why when Lazarus died, he went into the lap of Abraham, a saint, resurrected. And the rich man of the crook rabbis ended in hell. So, Abraham was a noble man, and don't make fake sons of Abraham through circumcision. Don't dish out circumcision, dish out for money. They wanted to make disciples. That's why Jesus said they will go a long, long way to make one disciple. And when they have made him, they put a millstone of ritual around his neck and bury him down. Kill him. Mary Magdalene was set free of those rituals. 7 demons of menorah. All these things come from your heart. Once you have used the common sense to learn gospel from our supernatural Father inside you. Inside you. Same common sense you can use to make, cheat people to make money. And your head will be full of sins. And knowing very well that when you go to God, God will ask you, and then you can't justify what you did. So in this dark age of Christ, everyone has to give his own account to God. Nobody can give your account. As the rabbi used to give the account at Passover. So with this note, I can tell you that today, the same people are returning as Moses brought them back from the Exodus. Today, Jesus came and preached gospel, but they rejected gospel in favor of cheating people, crook moral laws. And today they are brought into the promised land as unfaithful to Abraham, unfaithful to Yahweh, Jew, physical, not spiritual. And that's why the western wall of the temple is left. West is the direction of repulsing Satan for them to worship, because Satan can worship the western wall, whereas the sons of man worship east. They face east when they worship the God. So that's why the door of the temple is towards east. East, the primary source of light, sun. So many things I can tell, but YouTube people, they don't like bitter gospel. They give me a strike and take my video off the screen. So anybody who wants to have a documentary made or a film made, I can write a script for them and give them guidance, you know, of the gospel truth. Remember that second coming of Jesus, he was Nanak in India. He was a Satguru. Satguru means Christ. And he was not a guru. Guru means a rabbi, a Brahman guru, a rabbi, moral teacher. He wasn't a moral teacher. He was spiritual preacher of the highest order. And he preached gospel for 150 years through five more lives. Still the darkness could not be comprehended. And there were four royal kings to safeguard Sikhism. And still, the Satan was very powerful. There were kings and emperors of darkness against Judas Iscariot, a prince of darkness. He repented and he killed himself. In India, no way. They are jubilant if the Christ died. So, our Father God blesses everyone in agape, unconditional divine love. In Moses, he created arrows here, arrows, and no more fighting, or the snake was lifted up. Here we have agape on international basis, and here we are peacemakers on international basis, and not on this tribal basis. Of flesh, this is our soul. In soul, the whole world, we have one father, we are all his sons. Here everyone has his own tribal father. So this agape is much stronger than the arrows. And we should lift cobras, our international fighting between countries, but these priests are, talk of the priests are, they are the legacy of those husbandmen. Remember the last parable Jesus delivered in the temple was winepress. And the winepress is the temple who were making the moral laws, old wine. And they were corrupting it at Genesis 17. So that's why prophets were sent and they beat them up. Zechariah they killed in the temple itself. His last one was John the Baptist, the cornerstone of the temple. So they did not let him enter the temple. And he was in the wilderness, put on the camel skin. And where are the temple priests? They were putting on silken clothes and living in big, big palaces. As today you can see the bishop living in a big palace in the town. And these are the legacy of those husbandmen. And Jesus told them, these husbandmen are no good to do any other job than the job of a priest, ruling priest. And that's what they are, you know. In Church of England, the bishop, Church of England bishop, they sit in the House of Lord by their right. Whereas the Salvation Army or other bishops that doesn't belong to the Church of England, they cannot sit there. Church of England is headed by Queen or King now. They had died, but our church of God, our head is Christ Jesus, he never died, he is eternal. So this Church of England is a church of Satan, and it is racist. That's why the tree is known by its fruit. And I have found that these white people, British, They are racial to their bones. I have more than 10 cases of racism against me. And nobody is helping. You go to the ombudsman does favor to them. They all think that black people have no brain, and that is in their head. They do whatever they like. So, our Father God blesses you. Everyone has to give his own account to God. So we have nothing to worry, because then when you die, then you face God and you can give your justification. Our Father blesses you.